Reddit user SexySexyBubbles01. This happened about 2 years ago and still scares me when I think about it. First, a little background. I live in the UK and am from a smallish area, nothing fancy. I'm 18 and at the time I was 16 and working at a family friend's pub collecting glasses. I'd work from 7-11 at night and I lived about half an hour to 45 minutes away. To get home I had to walk through a park. Now this park has three entrances, exists two at the top and one at the bottom which lead into the town center, main shopping area. The top two lead to two different areas, one is a skate park and the other is literally right next to a comprehensive school and a big field. This park had a lot of bushes and trees in it and only has a few lights. These lights shut off at around 10:30, only lights on are the lamppost outside each entrance to the park which are very dim. Each entrance was a big gate and they were always open, this is important for later. I had to walk the path that lead towards the school since it was the fastest way home. On to the story. I worked at the pub for a year and had stuck to the same routine going home, not smart I know. I'd leave at around 11 sometimes a few minutes before sometimes a few minutes after, it took about 10 minutes to get to the park so I'd be walking through the park at around 11:30 sometimes or 15 minutes past. Now the one entrance I had to use to get into the park was the one at the bottom, the one that leads to the shopping area. It had one lamp post outside the gate and that was it. That was the only light so I could see about 10 foot into the park and there was a few benches, no one was ever in the park when I walked through it from work. During the autumn, winter weeks it was always empty even the streets were, so you could imagine my shock when I seen a man sitting on the bench as I walked through the park gates. Now this was so strange, it's around 45 minutes past 11 almost 12 at night, it's pitch black and freezing and this dude was just sitting on the bench. I couldn't see him too well at first but as I got closer I got a good look at him. He was young about 20-25, long hair and a ponytail but not a scruffy one, tight and neat. He had a hoop earring and his nose was pierced. I can't remember his eye color, he was so pale and his hair was jet black with red tips which went past his shoulders. He wore all black, he dressed like an emo TBH. Looking back now he kinda reminds me and looks like Dracula from the movie Van Helsing. He was on his phone and looked up at me as I walked towards him and he just stared at me as I walked past. I gave him a slight nod and smile and kept walking, he just looked me up and down smirking which freaked me out. He didn't say anything and I managed to get home and didn't think much of him and forgot about it. The next night I went to work, finished my shift and walked through the park and again he was there, on his phone wearing all black hair and a ponytail. He looked up, seen me and smiled, I smiled back but walked a bit faster past him. Again he said nothing. This happened the next night but on the fourth night he wasn't there. I walked through the park as usual but I felt so uneasy. It was pitch black, no light except for the moon and what do I hear? Footsteps, quick footsteps behind me so I turn around and ... nothing, absolutely nothing. I wasn't taking any chances so I ran through the park and I swear over the sound of my heart beating fast and my footsteps I heard twigs snapping and leaves crunching. After that I started getting a lift home for about 2 weeks from a friend, then that friend went on holiday so I had to start walking home through the park again. First night, which was Monday night, the man wasn't there but I still felt uneasy, like I was being watched. Second night he was there, sitting on the bench smiling looking at me but this time he spoke, in a very deep voice he said, "Hey baby, love the tights and skirt." Damn, I was wearing a black skirt and sheer tights with thick black thigh-high socks and Doc Martens with a black biker jacket and thick scarf. I had to wear all black for work. I looked at him awkwardly, smiled and hurried away. The next few weeks he'd be in the park and make sexual comments but always sat on the bench. I'd try and get lifts home when I could but I'd still have to walk through the park most of the time. Lord, I hated that walk. One night things escalated, I walked through the park as usual and again he was there sitting smiling at me. I did my best to ignore him as he made comments about my body and what he wanted to do to me. As I was walking away, I was out of the light and could only see 2-3 feet in front of me. I must have been about 20 feet away when I heard running behind me. I turned around and bam, someone runs into me full speed and knocks me to the floor. I feel a heavy weight on me and instantly I feel hair on my face and a hand over my mouth. A familiar deep voice tells me not to fight and that it'll be over quicker if I don't fight. It's him. He's on top of me and his hands start to wander down my tummy and he starts to lift my skirt up. I hear his zipper and he's rambling about how he knows I want this and how he's been waiting to do this for so long. He took his hand off my mouth and that's when I took my chance. I bit him hard, real fucking hard, and he screamed. He sat up off me and I could barely see, but he was holding his hand and cursing at me, so I took that opportunity and pushed him off me and got up. I started to run and I heard him running after me. I ran towards the first gate, the one I usually use to leave, and was shocked and mortified to see it was locked somehow. I could see it had a lock on it because the lamppost on the other side shone onto the usually open gate. I was so confused, but I could hear him shouting and I started to run again and I ran towards the other gate and it was closed but not all the way. There was a small gap so I squeezed through. This was the skate park gate. I just managed to squeeze through as he tried to grab me and I turned and looked at him for a few seconds catching my breath. He stared at me and then started to try and fit through the gate, so I booked it as fast as I could. I ran towards the skate park path. The skate park was full of bushes, on one side of the path that ran through it. It also has a long dark path which after about a 20 minute walk down it leads to a main road, but it's usually completely dead. I ran through the skate park and hid in the bushes waiting for him, since if I had ran onto the long path I'd be visible and he'd be able to see me and chase me, and since no one was around I'd stand no chance. The path that led to the roads had very few lights but still had enough so he'd see me and be able to find me. I sat in the bushes hiding with my hand over my mouth. I sat for a minute when I seen him running through the skate park looking for me. He slowed down near the exit path which leads to a long path and he literally stood there for a minute sniffing the air. No joke, he was sniffing the air. His hair wasn't in a ponytail anymore, it was all over. He wasn't wearing a coat, he wore a long-sleeved shirt all black. It was winter, which confused me since it was so damn cold. He looked around and I felt his eyes scan me. Then he kept looking and started walking down the long path. After about 10 minutes I felt it was safe and ran back towards the park and ran into the park and ran to the gate I usually go through to get home. It was still locked so I climbed over it. I walked towards the school, following the path I always used, and had a strange urge to look back and there at the gate the man was standing, just standing watching me. He laughed and said, "I'll catch you one day, baby girl, mark my words." And he blew me a kiss and walked away into the darkness. I have never been so scared in all my life. I booked it home and told my mom what had happened. She called the police and council and asked why the fence was locked. The council was just as confused as I had been because they never locked the gate, ever. The police couldn't do much, they put a warning out and that was about it. The creepy thing was, he had to have learned my pattern. He had to have known I used the park every night to get home. It creeps me out to this day knowing I was being watched and could have been assaulted or worse. I still have nightmares from time to time about him and wonder what would have happened to me had I not gotten away or had he seen me in the bushes. I quit working at the pub and haven't used the park since. So creepy park guy let's not meet again. So, I can't post the diagram I drew, looks like a toddler's crayon doodle TBH. So I'm gonna kinda describe the park shape and the skate park path and the dark wooded path near the road to the best of my ability. okay for the park pika isosceles triangle upside down, the entrance I use which is attached to the shopping center at the top, the single point. That entrance has a big black rusty gate with a street outside and a few houses. It has one dim lamppost that lights it up but not enough to see far into the park, only about 10 feet. The bottom of the park, the bottom of the triangle, the two points are the other two entrances. The skate park and the school. Now if you walk to your left you'll be at the school fence which is the same as the entrance. It only has one lamppost. Now if you walk to right about 300 meters maybe more you have the skate park entrance and it's the same one lamp post, big rusty black gate. In between all of this are big thick bushes, no lights and it's pitch black. Now the skate park entrance has a long dark path you have to walk down for about 70-90 meters, just guessing, and then on your left is the skate park. It has a fence around it and bushes all around it. On the right are loads of bushes. The skate park itself has another path that's just as dark and surrounded by bushes that is so creepy. That path leads to a main road, but it's a long dimly lit path surrounded by bushes and thick trees. I call it a mini forest. Now if you walk down it for a while you'll be at the road. It's pretty dark and long and you would be visible if you ran down it. The school path, the one I usually took is short. It's about 100 feet and only has one lamppost till you reach the school which isn't as lit up as you'd expect. That path leads around the school to another path with a main road and loads of houses. That path leads to my home after a while if I walk directly down it. The man would always sit at the entrance of the park, the top of the triangle and he'd always be on a bench. I had ran towards the skate park which again has no lights because they shut off after a certain time. This skate park is surrounded by bushes and trees. Had I just kept running towards the dark path that leads to a dark road I'd have been caught since I would have been visible due to the dim lights and I'm not a fast runner. Hopefully you can picture this in your head, fingers crossed, if not I'll still try to post the diagram. Update. Okay. I posted a story here about something that had happened to me when I was 16. The creepy park stalker is back. It started about 6-7 weeks ago, with the lockdown going on I couldn't go to the gym or do my kickboxing lessons so I decided to order some gym equipment and go on long runs again. I do run but not as much as I do now. I go through the woods near my house to go running and the woods are thick and with the lockdown going on barely anyone is using the running trails. I use the same one every time I go running since it's the longest one. Now this wooded area is huge. I ran one of the main trails which was extremely long and in all honesty it is secluded and the woods are dense. I've been using the trail for a while now. There used to be about 10-15 other joggers using it but with the lockdown there's only about 3 or 4 people including myself who run it. Anyway, I got up around 6 o'clock in the morning on Friday and got my shorts and sports top ready for my usual run. I had a quick shower and got ready. I always take my phone since I listen to music while I run. I got to the woods and started to make my way to the normal jogging path I take. I get there and started to jog slowly. About 20 minutes into the jog I had the worst feeling in my stomach, not exactly feeling of being watched but a feeling of extreme nervousness. Now I do sometimes get creeped out running especially since it's through thick woods. It can be an eerie feeling so I kinda brushed off the feeling for a while but it got worse. I took one headphone out and kept jogging and I started to hear someone running and I started to relax thinking it was just another jogger. I couldn't tell if it was a man or a woman. It wasn't strange to me since like I said although there wasn't many joggers using the trails anymore you would still get a few from time to time. A lot of the usual joggers were middle-aged couples or young adults running alone. As they got closer and I could hear them breathing I was starting to think it was a man. I looked behind me and I seen it was a guy. He was wearing tight black running pants or leggings, to know what you call them. He had a black hoodie on, black trainers, black socks, basically all black, switched the hood over his head. Now as I seen his hood was up, I quickly looked for it again, and I honestly did feel nervous since I couldn't see his face at all. He started catching up to me, and eventually after about 5 minutes he started jogging past me, and he slowed down and we were jogging side by side. He looked at me, and when he did I almost pissed myself then and there. I was so shocked because now I could see his face. He had taken his hood down. It was the same man from the park from so long ago. It was the exact same fucking guy who chased me. I was honestly fucking mortified, and I still am. His hair was the same, the black and red long hair, very tall, well over 6 foot. He had his hair in a ponytail, and he still had the earring, but he had both ears pierced from what I seen. His eyes, I'm not going to lie, they weren't scary, they were actually beautiful. They were gray like a husky's eyes. I don't know why, but I thought they were so beautiful. I still felt shocked and terrified, but those eyes, I just think they were stunning. We locked eyes as we jogged, and I started to slow down, and so did he, and after a short while he broke the silence by saying, "Hello baby girl, long time no see ... I've been looking for you." I was taken out of my trance by his deep voice, and I got a hold of myself, and I quickly turned around, started to run as fast as I could back towards the start of the trail, towards home. He chased me, I could hear him, and he was growling ... fucking growling like a wild animal as he chased me down, yelling things about how I had grown and how my body had matured so much since he last saw me. I'm not gonna lie, I did go through a bit of a sort of growth spurt in my chest area. I get a lot of creeps mention that, and my boobs did grow huge, and he didn't hide the fact he had noticed since he made a canny few gross comments about them. He was shouting, and TBH I'm shocked he was even able to shout while we ran. I guess looking back now, it's how I was able to stay ahead of him since he didn't run fast because he was shouting to me. As I was running, I could see the break in trees where the trail starts, and I was so happy I was so close to home. He kept shouting to me, saying he had missed me and he had spent so long looking for me, and how he could wait to feel me again. Everything he said made me feel sick to my stomach. I kept running and pushing myself, and God, it hurt. I could taste the blood in my mouth from running so hard, and I thought I was going to be sick. As I got to the trail entrance, he must have stopped running and shouted to me, "I'll always find you, and I'm not gonna lose you again, Jesse." The fucker knew my name. I don't know how he found out what it was, and I still don't. I ended up running home, and as soon as I got to my door I threw up. I don't know if it was the shock or from running so much. My mom came running to me and asked what was wrong. I explained to her what had happened and what the guy had said to me, and she was furious and shocked, and my stepdad was just as angry, if not more so. My mom called the police and told them what had happened. The police came out and took a statement and said they would keep an eye out and had patrols out around my neighborhood for 3 days, but nothing came of it. After about a week, the incident kind of faded into the background and life continued, but another week later I was at home in bed watching a video on YouTube, and it was late at night, I'd say around 2-3 in the morning, and I heard my garden gate open. Now my front garden has a camera, but the back one doesn't. I don't really know why, I think it's due to my mom wanting to give me privacy, since the cameras aren't proper outdoors ones, so they are placed right outside the window with the windows open slightly for the wires, and since it records things you can hear conversations in my room. Anyway, my room faces the back garden, and that has a massive fence around it. The other garden does have a fence, just not as big. I hear the gate open and shut. I got worried someone was gonna burgle my house. Around my area there had been a few break-ins and assaults, so I went to my window, pulled the curtains back a tiny bit and opened my window a bit and looked into the garden, but I couldn't see anyone. I snuck downstairs into the kitchen since it also faces the back garden and went to look outside. I kinda belly crawled to the window and peeked outside, and there was someone standing looking at my back door. They just stood not moving, staring at the door. They wore all black from what I could see, and they had their hood up. I couldn't see any facial features, but from the angle of their head I could see they were looking at the door handle. I quickly went back upstairs and woke my stepdad, who at first didn't really take me seriously until we heard something. It was the sound of the back door handle being jimmied. It wasn't a super loud sound, but fuck, in the dead silence of the house it was noticeable, and at that time it was the most worrying noise ever. My mom woke up confused and asked what was going on and what the noise was. My stepdad explained to her someone was messing with the back door handle, and she started to panic. Me and my stepdad quietly went downstairs while my mom stayed upstairs. My stepdad and I could hear the door still being messed with. As my stepdad got to the door, it all of a sudden just stopped. The door was locked, and we have a chain lock as well as the normal one. My stepdad had his hand on the handle, and it slowly started to move up and down. My stepdad yelled at the top of his lungs in an angry and intimidating voice, "Who the fuck are you, and WTF do you want?" My stepdad's a big man, and he used to be a fighter and bodybuilder. He is not soft and is very intimidating, and he has a loud and very deep voice. The guy on the other side of the door stopped. It went silent for a minute, then we heard something something that honestly scared the shit out of me. "Guess I'll have to come back later, baby. I've missed you so much." It was him. It was the stalker, and at that minute I burst into tears, and my stepdad unlocked the door and the chain lock and swung it open, but the guy was running towards the fence and hopped over before my stepdad could get a hold of him. My stepdad came back inside the house and my mom called the police. They came, took a statement, looked around my garden and in the bushes, and then left. They told us to call back if he came back and tried anything. A patrol car stuck around all night and then left in the morning. My mom and stepdad told my younger siblings what happened, and they were scared. I was freaked out that he knew where I lived and realized he must have followed me and must have been watching me run the trail, but I never ever seen him, or at least I never noticed him. For the next few weeks, strange things have been happening. Flowers would be dug up out of my next door neighbor's garden and left outside our back door. Stones get thrown off my window at odd hours of the night, and notes with really dirty poems are left stuck to the kitchen windows or posted at the letterbox. We're putting up a camera to see if we can catch him in the act, because we can't really prove it's him, and the police need to see him in action to catch him. They have patrols, but they never catch him. It's been escalating. My clothes are disappearing off the washing line, mostly bras and undies, but my vest tops, crop tops and shorts and skirts have gone too. I actually have only 3 bras left, and I've had to order more bras and panties. Even my mini dresses are gone, but my jeans and jumpers and tops are left alone. We actually found 2 of my bras a few days ago hung up in a tree not far from my house. Stuff like this happens a lot now. He also placed a dead pigeon outside the door with a few necklaces around it about 2 weeks ago. We've had police come out, but TBH they seem reluctant to do anything except take pictures for evidence. The activity has stopped at the minute. It's been 3 days since anything has happened, but I'm not sure he's truly gone for good. I'm so worried, I honestly don't know what to do anymore. I'll update if anything more happens though. Thanks for watching. Subscribe.